Hey folks, so yesterday the Alex uploaded a video asking people to explain to him what Brexit would mean to them personally. Now, I'm pretty sure he'll try and use it to say shit like, see, this proves that you worship Hitler, or some idiotic shit like that, because of course everybody is a Nazi who isn't a super duper far left extreme left wing authoritarian. But I figured I'd give it a shot anyway. An honest to God old school video reply, and I'll try not to be an asshole about it. So why, what does Brexit, what would it mean to me personally, even though I'm not even a UK citizen? Well, what it would mean to me, first of all, is that if Brexit were to actually happen, it would set a precedent and it would cause a cascade effect in the rest of Europe of other countries to follow, because, let's be honest, pretty much every country, there's a lot of people. I'm pretty sure that most people are just sick of the EU and they want to just get out of it. But because, you know what it's like, we're all being threatened basically into staying, because that's what the EU does. And now, what does the EU do? Well, basically, they just exist to tell countries what to do. I mean, we all used to be like sovereign countries. We dealt with each other, we had trade relations, and we had our politics. But now here is the EU basically trying to enforce the same thing, but then really from the top down, just telling us what to do. And it's fucking ridiculous. But now, I mean, we all know that EU forces all EU countries basically to take in refugees by the millions, and there's nothing we can do. We have to, because that's the EU. Do as we say, or else. And then it goes into fucking insane little details. Like I said it before, I'll say it again, and I will be fucking outraged about this till the day I fucking die. My goddamn coffee maker, if I make coffee, it automatically shuts down. Why? Because the EU demands it. It's actually a law passed down from Brussels by the EU, making sure that we do not have a coffee maker that stays on longer than half an hour, or that we can buy actual fucking light bulbs. And it goes on and on and on. For years they've been trying to recriminalize marijuana in this country. Why? Why? Because the top dogs, Germany and France, they don't like legal weed. So, because they're the two main players, they keep trying to curb it. And it just goes on and on and on. And what do we get in return? What do we get in return for giving up our sovereignty, for basically cowering and bowing down to this big fucking entity that is just ruling us from the top down? Well, we get to pay them millions and millions of euros on an annual basis, just so they can use it, well, first of all, to wine and dine themselves, because it costs millions. They waste millions and millions and millions just with all the European ministers and all the little employees and the whole massive bureaucratic red tape blob that is the EU, which basically, in, well, first of all, it exists basically, like I said, to enrich themselves, to have their little meetings and their millions and millions of dollars costing little get-togethers where they sit around and eat caviar and smoke fucking Cuban cigars, whatever the fuck they do, something that is completely fucking utterly useless for the rest of us. And what do they with the rest of the money? Well, they piss it away on money pits like fucking Greece or countries like Spain, where they use millions and millions and millions of our money to build fucking airports which they never use, and fucking retarded shit like that. And of course, all the money also gets used to fucking pay human traffickers to actually make sure that they go into fucking Africa basically and just scoop up people just so they can import them over here. Just so for some reason, the EU has a vested interest in just Islamizing the entire fucking European continent, for some reason. Now, they probably have the reasons why, and we can only guess to what they are. Although some of them are just overtly clear, they want it for the votes. I mean, look at Germany. If Angela Merkel, if she hadn't decided that Europe and especially Germany gets flooded with migrants, she wouldn't have had the amount of votes necessary to desperately cling on to her position as chancellor. So that's one of the main reasons. And of course there's like cheap labor, and then there's of course this whole white fucking guilt thing, although that's probably mostly drummed up. So the plebs, the rest of us, the retards who actually fall for it, that they buy into it and they ate into it. But I'm starting to ramble. So yeah, what is it? At the end of the day, the EU is nothing but a parasitic entity. It tells us what to do, and if we don't comply, they'll fucking make us. It's like, well, nice country you have there. Be a real shame if something were to happen to it. So better do as we say and give us your lunch money. It's just a parasitic entity. It's no different than the fucking mafia. They barge into your store. They tell you what to do. They better do what the mafia says. And in return, you get to pay protection money. Yeah, wonderful fucking protection we're getting from the EU. Wonderful protection. Just flooding the country with Islamists. I mean, the fucking crime stats alone prove it, especially in Germany and Sweden. So yeah. Why do I need Brexit? To kick off Mexit and to make sure that the entire fucking useless EU mafia gang basically gets disbanded. And we can get back to doing what we did before. And I mean, they like to, people like you, Alex, you like to fearmonger how there's going to be no more trade and the economy is going to collapse. That's a load of shit. We can trade without the EU. It's not like the EU magically creates a need for goods and services and all that stuff. That'll always be there. We'll still have Rotterdam, the second biggest port in the fucking world. I mean, our trade is going to be just fine. Just like the trade of the other countries is going to be just fine. Because we shall trade amongst each other and with the rest of the world. And the rest of the world will still trade with us. Because we get what they need, they get what we need. And we'll figure it out. Without some fucking parasitic entity just muddying the waters with bullshit rules and just taking their cut, for in return we get absolutely fucking nothing. Well, we get a lot, but it's nothing really positive. So yeah, that is what Brexit would mean to me. So yeah, and I figured I think I did a pretty good job not being an asshole about it. So yeah, my two cents. Everybody, have a great fucking weekend. Even you, Alex. And they're still going.